A song!
As I walked out on Broadway one evening in July,
yeah, I headed straight for land,
sir! It's the way you send it, my dear Annie. Oh, you're a little girl, can't you dance the polka? To Tiffany, I took her, I did not mind expense.
Three, short no sail!
Throw the mains! Hold down and clue up!
Anchor!
Captain, how's the helm?
Clues down! Back to the wind! Loose all! Let's move!
Pull off, lads! Loose the royals!
The city of Albany, sir. The greatest frontier town of them all.
Ease off the wind!
My thanks.
What is your business here?
That's none of your concern.
With respect, sir, it is.
You can't be taken!
What are you doing for?
None of that here, Fred. Up with you.
Volunteer for the army.
I think we should all find a way to get along.
I was a fur trader in the Ohio country, but I had to leave.
Let me guess. My eyes are still.
Yeah.
Swedish Academy of Letters has been founded in Stockholm.
Yes.
Darby runs a tight ship, and we're always looking for a way home.
You're here. Congress is still in session. George Washington and his militia have fired on French troops under Jumonville. The French are calling it an act of war.
George Washington. You mean Lawrence's younger brother?
Yeah, it's the same. Speaking of Lawrence Washington, but you eliminated him. James Wardrop has moved up in ranks. All the Templar resources are at his disposal now.
What about the manuscript?
My sources in New York confirm that Wardrop has it. I also learned that he is here at the Congress under heavy guard.
Shay, find Wardrobe. Get that manuscript.
This place is thick with Templar troops. Liam and I will make sure he doesn't escape.
C'est beau. Oh. Magnifique. Quelle splendeur. Je n'ai jamais rien fait.
As an artist, I painted a portrait.
Well met, sir. How fare ye? Which of my treasures might tempt you today? My gratitude, God.
Academy of Letters has been founded in Stockholm.
What business can't we?
Must be the Templar William Johnson. Perhaps he has the manuscript, or knows where it is.
As I have stated previously, I believe we need a national union, granted by an act of parliament, but bringing greater independence to our colonies. The French are an immediate threat, and we are ill prepared to face them. To put it bluntly, the colonies must join or die.
Rousing speech, Master Franklin. But do you truly believe Great Britain will grant her colonies autonomy?
They have little choice, Master Johnson. You know the remoteness of this frontier better than most.
Yes. But let us leave politics for another day. I wanted to thank you for your research.
Of course. Of course. In the brief time I could examine that box, I could tell it was something unique. From ancient Egypt, you said? Well, as I mentioned in my letter, I am quite ready to electrify it.
Excellent. We will have the box delivered shortly. As for the manuscript, Captain?
I apologize, sir, but Master Wardrop refused to hand it over. He said the risks were too great.
The risks? Ah. I apologize. You will have the manuscript and the box in the briefest of delays.
You mangy excuse for a uniform. Run to Fort Frederick and tell Master Wardrop he had better cough up the manuscript post-haste, else I will have him scalped.
I can't let that lobster captain reach Wardrop.
George, I think we need a stronger colonial government.
Well done, soldier. Do not stop on my behalf. Again, young man, we will make a soldier out of you.
I'll take that, you Templar dog.
No! You have no idea what you're doing, fool!
Keeping the people free from your control.
How free will you be when the French undermine these squabbling colonies?
These colonies would be far better off without the Templars pulling the strings.
We bring order from chaos. If everything is permitted, no one is safe.
Even the devil can quote scripture to suit his own purposes.
Captain, how's the helm?